In this video, we'll be looking at how to write word and symbol equations. A word equation shows how chemicals react together in a reaction, changing from reactants to products. They are a simpler way to show the reaction compared to a written description of it. This is a relatively standard way to describe the combustion of ethanol, with extra information that is not relevant to writing the word equation. When you are given a description like this, you should be looking out for common words or phrases. For example, burns, which suggests a reaction with. To form, which indicates the reaction taking place as well as the reactants and products. In this case, the word and suggests more than one product is being formed. From the information, we get the following word equation. The word burns is represented by the plus sign. To form is shown by the arrow. And for carbon dioxide and water, the word and is represented by the second plus sign. Here are some more words or phrases that can be used in written descriptions of a chemical reaction. Using all of the information available, you should be able to write a word equation for any question. For some equations, you may need to deduce the name of one or more of the products. There are some general rules for compounds that contain two or three elements. We will use CaBr2 and CaBrO3 twice as our examples. CaBr2 contains calcium and bromine, while CaBrO3 twice contains calcium, bromine, and oxygen. When naming compounds, the metal typically comes first in the name. This means that both chemical names start with calcium. CaBr2 contains two elements, which means that the non-metal bromine is the second name or surname. The element bromine changes to bromide to show that it is chemically bonded in a compound. This means that CaBr2 is calcium bromide. CaBrO3 twice contains three elements, which means that the non-metal bromine is the second name or surname of the compound. But the oxygen needs to be considered. So, the element bromine changes to bromate to show that it is chemically bonded in a compound that includes oxygen. This means that CaBrO3 twice is calcium bromate. It can help to read the name out loud as it should flow. For example, bromineide does not flow naturally, but bromide does. The key information from question 1 is that carbon reacts with oxygen to form carbon monoxide. Since the question already has the reactants written in, you need to add carbon monoxide as the product for one mark. In question 2, the formula of limestone is CaCO3, which means there is calcium bonded to carbon and oxygen, and the 8 ending should be applied. This gives the chemical name calcium carbonate. This means that the key information from question 2 is that calcium carbonate is converted into calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. So, the reactant in this equation is calcium carbonate, for one mark. The question tells you that the two products are calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. Both products are required for the second mark. Question 2 is a good example of how marks can be split in two-mark word equation questions. Remember, word equation questions typically contain all the information that you require, so take the time to read them carefully. Like word equations, chemical symbol equations show how a chemical reaction happens. For example, the reaction of sodium with bromine forms the salt NaBr. Remember, NaBr is a compound containing two elements, which means that the bromine becomes bromide, so NaBr is sodium bromide. Therefore, the word equation is sodium plus bromine arrow sodium bromide. Replacing the words with the chemical formulae gives you the unbalanced equation Na plus Br2 arrow NaBr. Chemical symbol equations should have the same number of each atom on either side of the equation. A common mistake when balancing equations, like this one, is to put a small 2 on the NaBr, but this changes the chemical and is incorrect. You can only put big numbers in front of the chemicals to change the number of molecules. So, to correctly balance the equation, you should consider the amount of each chemical. It can help to draw out the chemicals. We have one sodium atom and one bromine molecule, forming one sodium bromide molecule. To balance the bromine atoms, we need a second sodium bromide product. This means that the sodium atoms are now unbalanced, as there are two sodiums on the right-hand side. So, we need a second sodium atom on the left-hand side. Overall, we have a balanced chemical symbol equation with two atoms of sodium reacting with one bromine molecule to form two sodium bromide molecules. Drawing out the molecules helps visualise the balancing process. The key information in part A is NH3 is made by the reaction of N2 with H2. Be careful as the information is written backwards with the product showing first. This means that the unbalanced equation is N2 plus H2 forming NH3 for one mark. The second mark is for balancing the equation. The unbalanced equation shows that one nitrogen molecule reacts with one hydrogen molecule to form one ammonia molecule. To balance the nitrogen atoms on the left-hand side, we must make two ammonia molecules. This means that we now have six hydrogen atoms on the right-hand side, which can be made using three hydrogen molecules. Overall, we have one nitrogen molecule reacting with three hydrogen molecules to form two ammonia molecules. Correct balancing gains the second mark. In part B, the symbol with two arrows pointing forwards and backwards shows that the reaction is reversible. This gains one mark. In part C, the key information is that NH3 reacts with HNO3 to form NH4NO3. This gives the equation NH3 plus HNO3 arrow NH4NO3. Looking at the question, we can see that the equation is for one mark. The equation is actually balanced and therefore gains the mark. In any question, it is always worth writing the unbalanced chemical equation because you may still gain one mark. Word and chemical equations show how a reaction happens and are shown as reactants forming products. The information required to write a word equation is given in the question. Look out for some of the common phrases like reacts with and is made from, amongst others. Symbol equations are balanced to follow the law of conservation of mass, which means that they show how many molecules of reactants are used to form a number of molecules of products. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.